Hello and welcome to Microbial Concepts. Today we are going to discuss about fungi as a biological control agent, that is a biocontrol agent. Okay, this is a MSc topic. You have this in applied microbiology. Okay, so we are going to discuss about some examples of fungi and on which kind of disease or pest these fungus are used. Okay, so first, what is a biological control, okay, or a biocontrol? What does it mean? It means reduction of undesirable organisms like insect, weed or plants by using a biological agent. Okay, so you can control unwanted insects, weeds means small plants which grow between your crop. Okay, so those also compete for the nutrition. Okay, so you don't want those weeds to grow. So to control those weeds and some other plants, you can use these biological agents. Okay, so what is a biological agent? It includes organisms or genes or gene products or some metabolites to control invasion or invasive plants, weeds or insect. Okay, so this is a biological agent, right? So here we are going to discuss about organism, that is fungi. Okay, fungi is used as a biological agent or a biocontrol agent, right? So what does fungus or fungi means? It is a group of eukaryotic organism that include unicellular yeast or molds, which are multicellular, and mushrooms. Okay, and mostly conidia are used for control, for biological control, as they produce continuously than the sexual spores. Okay, so this was about biological agent, biocontrol and fungi. Now let's start with some examples which are used against plant disease. Okay, so these are some fungi which work actively against some plant diseases. Okay, so Pichia inositovara or Pichia acacia are active, or they are used against different yeast, and the mode of action is cytotoxins which are produced by this fungus or these fungi. Then next is Cluveromyces species. It is used against contaminating yeast in shake. This is a kind of alcohol beverage and or fermenting rice. Then there is Trichoderma species, which is used against a causative agent for steam blight on potato, dry bubbles on mushrooms. Okay, so these are names of diseases. Then we have another, that is Penicillium gulleromona, which is used on Penicillium species that causes post harvest decay. That means after harvesting of your crop, during the storage or while the transport, this Penicillium, other species of Penicillium, they cause decay. Okay, and for controlling that post harvest decay, Penicillium gulleromona is used. Next example is Bacillus subtilis. Okay, so this is a bacterial example, but it produces benomoyl, that is an antifungal product. Okay, and that's why it is used to control brown rot of palms, peach, apricot, which are caused by Monalaria species. Okay, so benomyl is an antifungal product which is produced by Bacillus. It is of bacterial origin, but it has antifungal activity, so they are used here. Next is Phlebia giganta. It is used against Heterobasidium anosum, which is a bracket fungi and that causes root rot. Okay, so these were some examples of fungi or antifungal agents which are used against plant disease. Next is examples against herbicides. Okay, so these are some fungi which work actively on controlling weeds. Okay, that is some unwanted plants that grow between your crops, and they also compete for nutrition. Okay, so Alternaria, Fusarium, these are used for, yes, sickle pod, then velvet leaf weed, and Puccinia species, these are used for thistles. And next is Bipolaris, it is used on cogon grass. Next is against insects, so example is Neuromia rilei, it is used to control cabbage lupus. Then Bivaria bassiana is used to control pine moth. Then Entamophaga mimiga is used against Lamentaria disper. Then Ernia is used to control Hypera postica, which is alfalfa weevil. Then we have next, that is Cordyceps species. These are active against coconut root grub. Okay, so the Cordyceps species of fungi, they actually attack the larval stage of these coconut root grub, and they grow throughout the body of the larva. Okay, and eventually the larva dies, right? So this is how these fungus, they are used as a biocontrol agent. You will find some names difficult to pronounce and to remember also, but you have to do this for this question. Okay, at least write 4 or 5 examples for each category. Okay, so now next we have some some biocontrol fungus agents for nematodes. Okay, so nematodes are small microscopic needle shaped worms, and they are found in water and soil, and they are known to cause disease in crops, which causes high loss. That's why it is very important to control these nematodes. So to control nematodes, fungi can be used as biological agents. So example is Arthrobritis candida is known to act on nematodes by various mechanisms. Some of these fungi produces neurotoxins, due to which they are capable to immobilize the nematode, and they grow on the nematodes. While some fungi are known to form hyphal ring-like structure, okay, a trap, ring trap, in which these nematodes are trapped. Okay, so if this is a ring and this is a nematode, so that nematode will get trapped into that ring and it will not move. Okay, and thus the fungi uses the nematode as a host and it grows on it. Okay, then next is Arthrobritis brachophaga. It is one which forms a net like trap. Okay, so there are minute net like structure, mesh like structure formed, due to which these nematodes, they get trapped easily. Okay, so the ring like structure is formed by Arthrobritis brachophaga, and Arthrobritis oligospora forms a net like structure. Next is how to apply these biocontrol agents. So there are 3 strategies for inoculation of biocontrol agents. First is permanent inoculation, which involves establishment of fungi in that environment. Okay, at least it should have a proper establishment in that environment, so it will keep on acting. Okay, it is least costly but labor intensive, as periodic release of spores is necessary. Second is inoculum augmentation. It is used for diseases which are annual problems. Okay, for that you do inoculum augmentation, that is supplying the biocontrol agent periodically, okay, when required, right? Then environmental manipulation, it is done to produce pathogens antagonists. Okay, so these are 3 strategies which you can use for fungi as a biocontrol agent for inoculation of the particular fungi. Okay, so what are the advantages of fungi as a biocontrol agent? First is it is cost effective, then they are environmental friendly, third is non-harmful to humans and animals, and multiple targets can be treated, right? So these are some advantages, but there are disadvantages as well. So first is time is required for killing and it is more, okay. The mode of action is not quick, it requires time. Then second is high spore production is necessary to produce or maintain biological effect. Then third is if host target range is multiple, then it can also affect important insects which are necessary for crops, like they play a major role in pollination, they act as a vector, right? So even those insects which are necessary for crops, those may also get killed, okay. So these are some disadvantages, okay. So this question you may get for at least 3 to 4 marks or even 5 marks. So this much answer, and from each category 4 to 5 examples are okay. Okay, so do subscribe to my channel, like my videos, and do share these videos with your friends. Thank you.